before starting, let us know how is the people's energy levels going on, being a Saturday. So define what is in coming in your mind, the first word. Please type it across and let's see how the amazing things comes across. So all of you can write it across the one word which is coming to your mind while you're starting this webinar. Nice, it's money and very good morning, gratitude, growth. What else? So Madhusudana, I agree with you with a lot of gratitude and positive thinking, because today I was thinking in my myself, morning it's like a miracle happening. So it was nice. Long-term security. Nisha Shank, anybody else like to write it across? Grateful and thankful. Thanks, Robert. I should do that first to you all. So by the time people write it, so let me write, tell my today's morning. And I was feeling so happy and so high anyway. We have two servants morning and evening. And yesterday they both called up and saying that 3 days they are not going to come. And when we were walking in the morning, we walked from 6:30 to 7:30. And I was telling my friend, is it somebody who can come? Because it's easy to manage office plus vessels plus cooking, but sweeping and mopping is a big task, okay? Then I said, okay. She says, no, it's not coming for a few days and all. And I was just walking out the home. And I was telling her, maybe I'll skip 1 or 2 days for the sweeping and mopping because it's too much. And when I came home and I saw the servant was there and I was so surprised and I was feeling top of the world. I can think of if anybody housewives are there, they will feel the same. When in your mind and they have told you yesterday that they are not going to come, and when you come and say preparing yourself how to take care. And from that time, from 7:30 onwards, I'm saying, see how God has helped us, how a miracle has happened even though they told no. So today I was, at least my mind, I was feeling it's like a miracle and I'm top of the world. So I think so this is too good to start my day today. And yes, so it's nice to see all of you also having a nice gratitude thinking, long-term thankful. That really made us, all of us, to think positive, and a small things can make a lot of wonders, and I believe in that everything happens for the good, and always when you do good for somebody, it will happen a good back to you, some or other ways. It may not be the same person, but of course. So welcome back with the Right Fin Talk series, which we do every week to make sure that you are aware on the personal finance concept. Our intention is to make sure that you apply this and you become a little more better to go through your financial freedom and achieve your goals. And that's what our tagline always try to say, that guiding you to achieving your goals. So we are trying to do that path to make sure through webinars and with your family and friends, you will pass it on the same way and they will be also achieving their goals. My intention in these are most of the concept what we do in our company, what we do ourselves first personally, and the experience what we have with the different customers to share with you, which is a live examples, I can say, that is a differentiator. And I believe that we should not reinvent the wheel. Our intention is more on how to make sure that we learn and we go forward. So today when I was doing this seminar, I felt there are quite a lot of things which need to be done on a mutual funds. I have never done it. So this is my first series only on a product base. Normally I do it on a generic on, I can say service base like a retirement, financial, health, debt and anything. Debt planning is, I mean, loans and other things. So I wanted this series to happen in 2 to 3 different ways. Otherwise it's difficult for 1 hour to finish everything. So I can say you today, I'm taking a mutual fund as a series point one, then we'll do it. A second is what are the different types of mutual funds are there. And last but not the least, if you wanted to do the comparison, you wanted to know the different ratios of mutual funds, then that will be the detailing part of it. So depending on your interest, you can join series 1, 2 and 3. Today is talking about how a customer comes, and most of us and I feel very thrilled again today. Immediately after this webinar, I have two customers, which are the person you feel very happy because that's the first job they have done and they got the first salary this month, and their parents is, Rachna, I want you to guide them. And it is so nice feeling, even though I have not met them, that yes, they are starting on the right time. When you are young, it makes a lot of difference. You will yourself will see that. But very rarely will happen that first salary somebody is coming and meeting you to do it. So that is another good feeling I have it, because I'm going to meet after 12:30 two of them, which is just started their first job and the first salary they got it in hand. So today's agenda is, as a person who doesn't know anything about mutual funds, if they wanted to invest in mutual funds, how they can invest, how to choose their funds, and what is exactly the mutual fund. So this is the main crunch I'm going to talk today, about 50 minutes or, and then I will take the number of questions. So if not a mutual funds, what are the different options people have it? So somebody was telling me previously ki, why I need to have more returns, why I need to go for a mutual fund or stocks or whatever. So previously, if I start thinking about myself, I'm Rachna Rego, director of Right to Rises. My parents are army persons, so I'm ex-army person's daughter. So it's very different way when you look at from that angle. So I remember my parents will have FDs, or they will have PF, PPF, LIC. These are the three things. And gold was more on a jewelry, may not be coins or something, but more on jewelry side. These are the major things they normally invest with. But that investment was valid that time because the interest rates of the bank, they were getting 12%, 14% returns and all this stuff. But now it may not be good because we need to start looking a different option on how the taxation impacted. I'm not saying each different options are good in a different view when you are taking a asset allocation and diversification. So today my topic is on mutual funds. On others, we will take over the period part. So why mutual funds? Why somebody says that, okay, mutual funds. So this is a recent infographic we have made it for ourselves, where we have gone all time high as a Sensex and 53,000 mark. So if you notice here that Sensex first time when it is crossed was 5,000, and 99, it took 12 years to cross 20,000, and then it hit 40,000 after 12 years. Then it, 8 years to climb at 20,000 and 12 years to hit a 40. But in 2 years, it crossed 30,000 and 53,000. So this point comes to me very common, and I'm sure it must be in your head sometime, that the market is all time high. Should invest or not to invest? And this is not only for the, I can say, the person who are new or fresh or novice in this industry or wanted to investors. As a person who are very, very well, means in the part of the market and they're well versed investors, they also ask this question of, Krishna, is it good time to invest or not to invest? So my fundamental is totally different. I can tell you it's you can say at the personality level or a wealth management level. I always believe what is there in your hand, you can do it. What is not in your hand, you better don't try to change somebody. It can be as a personality or a spouse or a relationship or market. Market going and up is not in my hand. Neither I am God to tell that that market will go 1 lakh. Maybe going, the way it is going, there are so many parameters which make sure that we will have a multiple run also. But I cannot predict. Nobody can predict. If they say they can predict, they may be next to the God. But I don't agree that somebody can predict that by this year we will be 1,000 or 1 lakh. Yes, there are views what people say it may go well. So what is in our hand? Our hand is only two things. One is disciplined investor and continue to focus on our goals. What is my goals? I am not bothered somebody having a 300 crores. neither he's giving me 3 rupees, neither I'm bothered about what that he does with 300 crores. I'm bothered about my retirement, my kids' education, and myself. So am I able to do with the 100 crores or 2 crores? I'm happy-go-lucky. So why you think it is high? Because we are comparing with the past. But when you start, because nobody knows future. So if you think now, if we are already 2 years, as I say, 3 years back, now people were saying that why you didn't tell me that time is investing. That time also they felt it was all-time high. Because when you reach all-time high, so every day is all-time high then, correct? So most of the time, there is nothing called all-time high, nothing called it's a bull market. The best way is to do discipline, systematic, and then continue it. That is a better way to do it because you are taking a best of averaging. Because in the long run, we always know the market will go. So today I'm trying to do a little different presentation. I thought I'll try to put more from infographic, video, and storytelling. So you please give me your views also, how the pattern is.
To measure the velocity of a rocket entering the space, one should know what rocket science is, right? They say, before investing...
Can we have all person mute musicians?
I'm investing in mutual funds, one should...
Can you make me the co-host?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. You can continue.
To measure the velocity of a rocket entering the space, one should know what rocket science is, right? Vaisehi, before investing in mutual funds, one should know what a mutual fund is. And believe me, it's not rocket science. Main to 7 saal ki umar mein hi samajh gaya tha. उस चॉकलेट बॉक्स खरीदने के लिए मेरे पास पूरे पैसे नहीं थे, लेकिन मेरे पास एक आइडिया था, तो मैंने अपने एक फ्रेंड को बुलाया और कुछ पैसे जोड़े। But even then, फिर मैंने एक और फ्रेंड को बुलाया और कुछ और पैसे जोड़े, और फिर the shopkeeper told us to divide the chocolates proportionately. One coin, one chocolate. Two coins, two chocolates. Three coins, three chocolates. And that is the concept of mutual funds. Mutual funds has a large number of investors with one common investment objective. This money is then invested in bonds, equities, and other securities. The income that is generated is then distributed proportionately amongst all the investors. इसलिए तो कहते हैं mutual funds सही है.
I'd like to thanks to Amphi things because most of the today's things I have thought it's the best way to take it from Amphi as a straight away because they are the one of the authorities apart because Amphi is now linked to the SEBI. So Amphi take care of mutual fund, but SEBI is a umbrella which comes. So I have been taking data from mutual for Amphi database. So what exactly is a mutual fund? So if you notice this video very clearly, it says that it is a pool of money where all the investor pools with a common goal. So common goal, we will try to say it can be like a large cap fund or a small cap fund or equity funds or whatever we will say. We define the goals in advance and then we try to take a part of it and we will see what is the unit and any. So all of you who is doing first time listening here, please try to understand few words which we try using commonly, and I will not remember that it is done only for myself, and if you don't know, please let me know. Like an SIP is like a systematic investment plan, and this happens to me 4 years back. One of my customers said, Dashna, I have been doing an SIP from the bank, can you just come and tell me? And in my mind it's like a perception, SIP means an individual fund. So I said, okay, you give me the folio number, I will try to evaluate how good it is. And she's telling, no, that banker is telling there is no folio number. And I was telling, no, it's not possible. If there is a SIP, there is no folio number. So she said, why don't you come and tell me? So I said, okay, fine. So I went with her to the bank and I asked her, she's my good friend and she's been doing the investment with you. Is an SIP, can you just tell me? Because I'm trying to help her out to find out if it's a good one or how I can help to achieve her goals. And that person gave me the actual answer and which really made me to think that there is a different ways people use an SIP also. So you should be very careful. I always believe that instead of blaming somebody, it's better we become a clever person, and that's why this webinar series are. He says, you are doing systematically, madam. She said, yes, because I'm doing monthly. You are doing investments in our equity. Yes, that's also true. And it is in a scheme which is going into the all the stocks, which is a large cap fund. Then I said, where it is going? So he has put it in a ULIP plans, okay, which is going on month. So actually when he explained to her and I was there, I didn't have an answer. Because he said it is going systematically, it's going monthly, it is going in a share market, but actually it is an SIP, it's a systematic investment plan. So most of the time we interchange the meanings. So what he told is perfectly fine. So we are doing investment systematically and all, but we by default think SIP means in a mutual funds. So be specific when somebody is asking you for the any investments. What do you mean by SIP? Okay, that's one of the learning I've done, and I cannot say anything more because his definition as per him was perfectly fine. So mutual fund is good thing is that they, as you have seen, we have put a lot of people you cannot buy. So they put it in mostly 45 to 50 stocks. And then they will, at the end of a day, that stocks weights will tell about how much is your NAV, which is net asset value. So when you're going for the any of the purchase, you will always see that amount is like a unit plus cost. So here mutual fund is also as simple as unit plus cost. So number of unit and cost is called NAV. But this number, what is the difference between a mutual fund and I can say RD or maybe as in a saving banks or FD? So whenever there is a low risk funds or debt funds or whatever, so normally when you're going in a bank and asking that I wanted to do RD or I want to do FD, they will tell you in advance only what is the returns you will get. So that's the second learning I learned yesterday. One of my customer's daughter called me and she says, auntie, I wanted to invest 10,000 rupees as a one time. Can I do? I said, yeah, because minimum is 500 bucks you can do. So she asked me, what is the interest you're going to give? And I was just thinking, what interest she's asking me? I don't know. Is it, then I'm asking, is it you are asking your returns? You are asking what exactly? No, auntie, I wanted a returns name. I want only interest. So that is a, another word which is a common person use it as an interest because they're used to of FD, RD because they give them interest. So this is similar to interest, but it is not an interest because you are going to get the returns only when you sell. That day market returns or that day NAV, you will tell at end how much returns you have got it. So this is the second concept which I have learned last few days back is that interest is different and returns are different. So why somebody should do in a mutual funds? So why it is because if somebody has to do your own, you should know all stocks and sectors and market and all. So it is not so easy because when you are already been having your own work, your full time is doing. So it makes sure that somebody who is good is able to do it. So what they do it first is it is regulated by SEBI. It is a well-regulated government firm, which make sure that they are being managing professionally. Like yesterday I got it, not yesterday, day before I had one more FP doing, and that person is in a very good, I can say IT firm. And he told me, Rachna, actually I am getting 30% return in my chit funds. Why I should do mutual fund or an SIP? And he's doing a good amount of a chit fund. And I was just thinking, I am trying my best to explain that there is no power of compounding in that, there is no regulator, you can't get the net worth certificate, you are not getting the CIBIL report, you're not getting the loans, and I'm trying my best in a different ways to explain, but he says, no, no, because I'm getting a 30% return in that, I should not be able to do. And I said, what I understood from Chit Fund is mostly business guys, people do it because they are able to get the money in wherever they are sudden need, without a mortgage or without a loan, it's a soft loan kind of it. And I said, you are being a salaried people, I've never heard salaried people going for chip funds or something. And he says, no, if you can think that you can give 30% returns, so I'll be able to do SIP, otherwise I'll continue in chip funds. I said, fair enough, you give me, you have been doing the chip funds, they are doing for 20 months thing. You give it to me, all the data, whatever you have paid till date, and I will be able to tell you which is better, and please go ahead accordingly. So he gave it, he has taken some 5 lakhs chit, which is 25,000 he pays every month as per the chit fund. And he says how much every month he's been going paying for last 20 months. So like some months are 18,000, 22,000, 24,000, like that is he's given across. And I was surprised to know anybody can just write it. If you have such experience in a chat, how much returns and XIRR that person must be getting? Harsh 8. Anybody else? So he was doing a 2 chit funds and one Harsh, you are right, it was around 8%. And Jankiran, thank you, that's also true, which is 10%. And that is an actual, his bank to bank, and with an actual, I have done it. So this reminded me what a perception versus and what is an actual. And when I told him, and he was not even ready, and I explained what is an XIR formula works and how it works. But he says, okay, I'll go back to my chit friend and come back to me. And I said, yes, you are. Please go ahead and try to find it out. Because sometimes we just take an absolute and we have an assumption that, okay, I'm getting 30% returns. But when you do it on actual numbers, the answer is totally different. And this is the first time I did somebody on the actual number because I asked him to give me your bank statement with the number where it is debited. So these are the things which made us to think, it's better to do it, which is professionally managed, because we will have, they will have the fund manager who's focusing on the objective of that, which is transparent. You can redeem, you can take anytime the money out. It's a lowest cost and it can do start with even 500 rupees. To start with this, I wanted Nidisha to give a one first poll. So as per you, how many mutual fund companies are there in, you can say, in India? So we'll wait for a few more seconds. And it is almost true. Somebody can write the answer in chat. It will be great because I have been very generic to write it. So can we close and show the answer, Nidisha? Yes. So 38 people, 63% people says it is greater than 25. That is true. The answer is actually 44. So as on the last December 2020, it is 44 AMCs. Okay. So according to me, there are one AMC got an approval and one AMC has like a principal is joining Sundaram. So still should be the 44 only. So that's a part of it, why we should do our mutual funds. How mutual fund works, it's an investor, as I told, it pools the money. Fund house is like, we use another abbreviation of mutual fund companies as AMC, it's called asset management companies. And their fund manager will, if he's taking a large cap fund, so most of the time, as I will describe you later, but let me tell you on overall level, large cap funds as per SEBI is 1-100 rank, mid cap is 101-250, and small cap is 251-500. So ranking of all the stocks is already done by SEBI and they have to buy. So fund managers buy accordingly whatever the financial goal of that fund. Then it will generate the returns if those funds and the companies do well, and that it passes back to the NAV and goes to the investor. That is the way how the mutual fund works. The key investment consideration is always the best part is you can start anytime, you can stop anytime, you can diversify. If I have my own portfolio in a stock, I cannot take a 50 or track 50 stocks or something. It makes easier to convenience, you have a liquidity, and the returns are not, most of us, we are now doing the investment in FDs or RDs or anywhere. Like if I ask my mother why you used to do the NSE, and her point was because it doubled the income. So the concept of doubling of income went very high with her, and I'm sure many more people. So all those funds are taxable, but in these they are called as a capital gain. And they charge only 10% after 1 year, which is long term, and short term is below 1 year, which is talking about 15%. What are the different types of mutual funds? So I will concentrate more on the right side. Of course, there are, by constitution, they will have to declare to the SEBI this is a closed-ended or open-ended or intervals. I can say 80 to 85% are open-ended. Few of them are closed-ended, like you can give an example of ELSS fund normally people use for tax savings, which is closed-ended, which is for free. It's open-ended, but it is lock-in funds. Closed-ended is like where they say that it is not, you cannot buy and you cannot sell. Okay. Before FMPs used to come like that. Interval funds is in a, sometime they will say that investor can sell. Nowadays, interval funds are almost like negligible now. But major three funds which we will focus today is equity funds and debt funds and the cash funds, which is overall we are going to focus on today. This is the things which I have been telling in all my webinars is first we should, most of us, what we do it, and when I ask somebody, why don't you invest? And the answer comes very common that I don't have money. Or there is my salary is too low. I don't have. My expenditures are more. So they, I am not have to say anything. The Warren Buffett by itself says that don't save what is left after spending. But spend what is left after saving. So most of the time I keep telling, even our daughter who is just finished internship and she has got some money, and I told her, she said, what I should do? I said, first you should invest your 25%. Or whatever is earning, even it's an internship or your whatever, and then spend. So that concept has to get clear from the younger age, and I'm sure for ages and when they are being doing well, it works. And I don't say most of the time the absolute number. I normally say the percentage of it. The reason behind is now maybe we are earning around 5,000, 10,000 or 30,000 bucks, but afterwards, you don't know this 30,000 per month can become 3 lakhs or 30 lakhs. So percentage of the saving is more important than doing. And I will be a testimonial because I have been doing from the day one myself 25% of my earning till date. I've never missed it. So this is a small, again, video from MFI.
किसी को हार्ड रॉक पसंद है तो किसी को क्लासिकल, किसी को बॉलीवुड पसंद है तो किसी को रैप। जैसे म्यूजिक हर चॉइस और नीड को सैटिस्फाई करता है, वैसे ही म्यूचुअल फंड्स हर तरह के नीड्स और गोल्स को सैटिस्फाई कर सकता है। म्यूचुअल फंड्स सही है।
Today, if this is the story of a person whom I did last week, a person who has again joined and the first salary came, he asked me, auntie, where I should invest? And they said, no, their parents are banker, and they asked that, why don't you put it in MD? And the person who introduced to me, and she's auntie of that person, and she said, Rachna, they are not okay with this IP. I have given my details. Even she's been doing, she's a very good friend of mine for the last 25 years. And I have been doing, but somehow being in a banker, they say that their son also should do an FD. And I said, why you are trying to force them? You don't let them force, because that's something we have to learn ourselves. So she said, what you must have done if you were in that place or my place. I said, okay, find it out what how much you want to invest. So she said he wants to invest around 20,000 bucks. So I said, that's nice. Being a first salary, he wanted to start with 20,000. So I said, if I was in your place, I must have told yes, because you feel, your parents feel that FD is good and you are all times are with you. So why don't you do maybe 80,000 in FD per month or RD, whatever you can say, and 2,000 in SIP. Because that 2,000 is not a bigger amount, so you will feel bad or something. After 1 year and 2 years, you look around what you feel, what is your experience, and decide whatever you want. And that made him to think quite a lot. And I was very surprised. He went, he did his research, and at the end he says, I will do maybe 5,000 in an FD and 15,000, you know, doing an SIP. So sometimes, if we start pushing a person with our own belief system and our culture, it may not work. It's always try to go to find, ask few things. These are the only 3 things I ask any customer, even if it is a person who is just getting first time in a novice investor or the senior. What goal you are planning to do? So I ask that guy same question. Do you think you are coming into a tax bracket or not? Do you want to do take care of tax planning as a part of an SIP? So goals are different when we are with different age or retirement goal, because he's just started. So instead of asking of retirement or kids education or a gadgets or a house or a car, I first prefer to do it a tax planning. Then he said, no, I'm not coming into the tax planning bracket, auntie. So I don't want you to do any tax planning. So I said, fair enough. So what is the time zone? I said, we should normally try to look at 3 to 5 years plus. And he says, yes, I'm looking 5 years plus. And then I said, because you are young and you are looking 5 years plus, so we will go with the high risk, which is an equity fund. So these 3 things, whenever somebody is asking for get a mutual fund, any investments, find these 3 questions in your mind before you answer. What goal you are trying to link to that. So whenever we link our investment to the goals, we will never redeem or we will never withdraw that fund, because we know that this 10,000 I'm going for buying a car, for example. For 3 years I'm saving it, and after 3 years I'll buy the car with this money. I'm 100% sure you will never redeem that fund scheme, because you know that if I'm redeeming, my goal is not going to achieve. So the another learning is, normally whenever you invest, try to link your investment to that goal. Then you can say the goal is short term, long term, or medium term. I have been telling short term for us is below 3 years, 3 to 8 years, and 8 years and long more, because the funds what we give depends on those. Time horizons, very important, as I said, below 3 years, 3 to 8, and 8 and above. Risk. So most of the time, this question comes, do we have a risk? We have 100% to 200% risk. But how you can reduce the risk, that is what we should understand part of it. Because when we are working in a market, and market keeps going up and down. I keep saying it's like, people say this flat market. I said that even our lifeline flat doesn't work. We are no more. So it's a lifeline of the market is all the stocks. So it goes up and down depending on how the economy is and how all the macro factor works. So yes, it will go up and it will go down. So it will, when it goes up, we call a bull, and when it goes down, it will call bear. So this will take care 3 to 5 years. You will have a look. You can say bull, or you can say 3 to 5 years as a bear. Of course, it may have a flat market in between, but that's the way it works. So whenever we take a time frame, we always say keep in mind 8 years, because at least you will have one part of your bull which will take care of your all past returns. Because when you are in down, you are getting more number of units. So this story somebody told me, and then too, it's a homemaker. And that reminds me very beautifully. She told, Rachna, whenever we have gold goes down, I normally go and buy more gold because I'll get number of grams more. And I said, yeah, we are right. So she said, because when I sell them, then I'll get them more money. And then I felt it is so true with the same thing in a mutual fund also. That's actually the averaging time value money. Because whenever the market is down, and you should buy more, because when you're buying more, like how you get the gold grams more, you are getting here number of units more. And that unit is actually going to give you the more returns on an overall level part of it.
In a multilingual country like India, cricket is a common language 1.3 billion people speak. But do you know, this most revered sport in India has many similarities with investments. Let us have a look. Can you imagine a team of only batsmen? Never, right? We need a perfect blend of batsmen, bowlers and fielders to win the match. Similarly, to succeed in the game of investment, diversification is the only winning strategy. Just like a balanced team, we need a balanced portfolio to give us better returns. We can't hit the boundary on every delivery. Singles are just as important as boundaries. Similarly, we should invest in debt and equity. Equity provides us high returns when the market is good, and debt provides based on their track record for each format. Similarly, we have different investment horizons. Whether short or long term, we must select funds according to our goals only. Lastly, just like a captain is necessary to lead the team, similarly, we should have a professional to lead and guide us throughout the game to ensure the suitability of products we buy. So, we hope you will play this game of investment pretty well now and win the World Cup of your dreams. For more
Diversification and an asset allocation. Asset, maybe it can be debt and equity. You can have a gold, you can have a real estate, you can have different things. But too much of diversification is not good. So the another customer came to me, and when I was looking the portfolio, I'm so surprised he had 132 stocks for 10 lakhs of portfolio. And I was asking him, in my life I've never seen somebody having a one. So I was trying to say how much the person must have invested and return must have come. Just giving a random number in your mind. 10 lakhs for 132 stocks. His return was, how much somebody wrote it? I just saw some. 10%, 7%, 6%. His XIRR was 3%. So, and then for 6 years, okay? So I was keep saying, this I have done it maybe 1 or 2 years back, must be now quite high. What you are saying, it may be true by because market has done very well now. But I'm trying to say, we should not over-diversify. Have a very clear link. When we are trying to make a mutual fund things, we normally says, we'll take a 5, maximum 6 AMCs. Each AMCs, we can have maximum 2 stocks. So if you are taking a, for example, I'm just giving a random number, SBI one are doing in a debt and one you are doing in a small cap, for example, because you will do STP. That's the reason I'm saying. So make sure that you have a number of schemes and number of AMCs and other things and some limit where you can track. Either you track or you have given a professional to track, somebody should start tracking across. So sometimes it may happen because some funds are doing very good, we have taken and they're not doing. We should also realign. We are also trying to do most of our customers how to realign. It doesn't impact the taxation. But yes, over diversify is also not good for the long term. This is another thing which I came to know yesterday. I was also not aware of. This is a fact figure which says that less than 5% of a population directly invests in mutual funds. Any guesses who does the highest? In what, which place we will be investing the highest? Thanks, Antrima. My question is where we normally invest, yes, as an Indian. So this is the place where you can see this is the our So most of the places, the deposits are the highest in FDs. We have insurance 34%. Mutual fund is just 2 and shares are only 1. So what has been happening, if you have noticed last 3 or 4 years, mutual funds has been doing very, very good. Not very good, I mean to say that performance-wise, of course, I'm trying to say the reach-wise. Because SEBI has put that one of the clauses to all AMC, that 2 basis points, whatever they have a fund, they should do a investor awareness program. It is a mandate for them. Otherwise, if they're not doing that, money has to go to the SEBI, and SEBI and MFI will do that part of it. So if you notice what I was using videos, is a part of an awareness program done by MFI. And that's the reason last 4 years, the mutual fund has actually increased much, much larger way. The reach has gone much, much more larger way to make sure that people invest, because that is going to give you the wealth creation and the overall good return if you're looking for the longer term. This is a typical, I can say, I have been telling the power of compounding, how if you are young, and you invested much, much lesser to get a much bigger amount than the smaller part. So I'll just take you to the small calculator. Please let me know if you're able to see the calculator. Are you able to see the calculator?
Yeah, yes, ma'am.
So in the calculator, there are 4 things. Again, I will ask Nidisha to send this calculator, because I've been using this. This is my part and parcel on a daily basis. There are 4 things I have written. One is a calculator. You can just say how much you wanted to save. So let us say 5,000 for this person. And here I normally take a very conservative around 12 to 14% returns, even though it's normally it goes above that. And how much money that person will have it on an overall level. So that's the first point this calculator says. Another calculator is already having this. So if you wanted a number of years and what should be expected return. So for example, if you are saying I'm investing 5,000 rupees and the expected return is 10. In 5 years, how much money will be there? 10 years, how much it will be? 20 years. This is what it shows. So you can easily play around in this. Don't go over 15. Most of the time it's very tough. So it's 10 or 12 is the most conservative which I have seen. I can say 100% of our customers have got it at least 12% when they're looking for the long run. Even they have gone much more. So 10 to 12 is a good returns on an overall level. Another one is, most of the time we try to say in the monthly investment, I do this 10 years. What is my, it is called real rate of return. What is expected return versus inflation? We are doing this. So what is the difference value is coming? This is the another plan which I love to do it, is delay cost. I'm supposed to invest 5,000 for 10 years and I didn't invest for 5 years. I delayed for 5 years. So what is my value? My cost of delay is 7 lakhs. This is the another part I want all of you to play around, look around and then try to do it. You will have much, much value that yes, I am losing some money. So sometimes people say, Rachna, actually I didn't get the returns, I was just kidding and also to somebody. I said, you're not having returns, this is a different question. So many of us sometimes don't invest and you don't realize that 100% you have not having the money because it is just gone for the just savings or you have utilized in an expense. So today morning walk, one of the things which we were talking about, even though it's not related, I'm just trying to tell you because recently that new rule has come. If you have an FD, automatic renewal will not be happening. So in case if you have an FD and you wanted to continue the FD, please make sure when it is maturing and you need to go for an automatic renewals will not take care. It will start giving you only the SB account interest. So cost of lying down, just now I told, it is make sure that please keep it in a invested instead of putting in a saving banks because it's not giving you any value. Whenever it's not a mutual fund, whenever you have taken care of any asset class, in a long run, the market will always outperform. And this is the one of the graphs I'm sure you all must have seen, heard, and experienced. And please make sure you should look long term. So it's not that they will not give negative. I remember 1.5 years back, I used to get only two kind of questions at a time. Prashna, my SIPs are negative and FD is better. At least it will give me 6% or 7% return. You are not even giving that much. And as an advisor, my work is only to tell them that we are on the right track. Don't worry because your goals has not come. It's not impacting your goal. It will do that. That's the way our work works. Because market was so down, even an SIP is not giving you. This, it happened 3 years SIP. 2 years back, the previous was done 3 years, SIP was also negative. So it works only in long run. And sometimes that's one of the reasons people quit mutual fund because their experience of exiting on the wrong time. And that's what I want all of you to explain to your friends, family. Don't do the logical loss into the actual loss. Don't take a hasty decision. The advantage of mutual fund is, as I told, it's professionally managed, diversified. It's convenient. You can start with 500 rupees. Your returns are much, much higher, well-regulated, least tax benefit, not tax benefit. It's a least tax amongst any other things because long-term tax is only 10% here. Transparent, and you have multiple choice. So I ask you, how many, can I have a poll to Nisha? You want me to poll? How many mutual fund schemes are there in total in India? So 5 more seconds, we can wait. Thanks for voting. Can we have the answer? So it says yes. 25%, 25 people have told, which is 46%. It is 2,000 and above. And 17% says less than 1,000. And 37% says between 1,000. Actually, it is, again, this is AMFI data taken as on 30th of December 2020. It is 2,500. So now scheme must have increased, but this is the data which is published. So you can think of sometimes it's how tough it is to do 2,500 data. Okay. So it makes sure that when you want, try to go for the goal based and then go what need to be taken care. How easy? This is very easy to step because we have just done nowadays the best part of the mutual fund if you're doing first time. It is, it's called KYC, know your customer. So now good and bad part of the COVID, I can always is good part for us is that everything's become online. So now KYC is also online. They do the OTP based and you can become the take care of, know your customer. When you do the know your customer, it's easier to do mutual fund online. Mutual fund online goes as simple as I always explain people, it's like a home EMI. First time they are doing a setup and next time onwards, it automatically goes from your bank to the mutual funds houses. And then day, whichever day you choose, you can choose from any multiple days. If you are salaried people, I will prefer you to choose first within first 10 days because it's easier for you to make sure that you are all the investment and then you can expand. But sometimes people say, okay, why don't I take an average later on? So I always tell it's better to have an STP weekly basis if you're salaried and SIP take it as a monthly. So you can choose any day. So it's easier to try to say what are the investment needs. Like I said, you wanted a for taking care of your tax or if you want to take care for your retirement or if you want for your kids or you want to just we call wealth creation or accumulation. So you are trying to identify what willingly risk you are taking. You want a medium risk, high risk or low risk and what amount you want. You have to just choose that. Then you can find it out from the next level. Its past performance are always a good indicator. If this is a one time, maybe 2-3 years back, we were doing an advertisement in the radio. And somebody called me and he says, I never understand in a mutual funds ad, always it rush before the ad over. I said, I don't know, I didn't notice myself. Is it this? Because do you know what they always say? Anybody? It says that past performance is not indicator of the future. Read the document carefully. That's a word sentence they always say. And that is true. It is like I keep telling everybody, the fund manager is like a driver of a car, and he never drives the car with a rear mirror. It always drives from the front mirror. So please don't just check the ranking and the past performance and then do it. And that was one of the things last week when I was doing a webinar, I said it, that all the Franklin Templeton 6 funds, the ranking and the past performance was showing on top. And within a 3 months, they were having an issue on cash flows. So most of the time, it's good to know all those ratios, but don't think that's the only things to do it. Find it out, which is good overall level. I can say things are there with you as a Google. Otherwise, find a friend, find somebody. Because most of the time, it's what is good for you may not be good for your friend. So try to do it your own goals and try to do. Select a scheme, mix of scheme. If you have a 10,000 bucks, put it in 4 different schemes. It can be large cap, mid cap, small cap, hybrid funds. If you want as an emergency, take a one debt funds. So that's a way you should choose and do it within a 1 month. How the EMI goes automatically, it will go automatically. So I have given actually a lot of examples after this. Now my time is up. So as I told you, I'll take this 3-part series. I'll just do now only the summary part of it. And then rest of it, I'll do the next session, which will go into much detailing part. What is the summary we have understood? Always try to have the investment goals. What is your goal? What is your time frame you're looking? What is the risk you can do? Do asset allocation and know the product before you invest. These 5 things will make sure that you will have the wonderful experience in investment and try to have the long term. Thanks a lot, and I'm open for the questions. I'm sorry because there was really a lot of data, and I will have the second session because next week we have an alpha series from our PMS team, which they run every month on month. So I will be doing the series part 2 and part 3 of a mutual funds after that. So I'm open for any questions. Thank you.
Nitisha,
can you tell me?
Yes, ma'am, I'll read. Yeah, so this question is from Pradeep. So when a new IPO is released, will mutual funds add it in their portfolio or is it there any cool off period?
Most of the time IPOs, they don't take it because they can't keep the cash till that time. In IPO, in an AMC, they are not allowed to hold the cash because you don't know. So IPO, even for our PMS, sometimes we have been applying, but we don't get an allotment. Till that time, the money has been parked in escrow. So in PMS, it is allowed, but we stop doing it because allotment doesn't come equally to all the shareholders. Similarly, in PMS, they don't, mutual fund, they don't do it.
Okay, the next question. Yeah. Ma'am, the next question is from Veera. How safe the AMC is in India?
So it's like that, how much I can trust an Indian government or an RBI, okay? So it's the same way a SEBI is being run by the government and it is very, very safe. I can give you the simple example, which I myself get amazed, which is very, very different, is Sahara. You will be surprised to know, and you can do Google search yourself, that they found there was some investors where they have made the fake names and they have done the investment in their names and all. Even though Supreme Court gave a bail, but SEBI didn't allow for that and he's still in the jail. So most of the time, SEBI has a much, much same or much bigger role sometimes than even Supreme Court if the things are not going good. So because I'm a compliance officer also, so I know that we do have to publish our data every quarterly and for PMS every monthly. We have a disclosure documents every 6 months. So actually they are very tight to do it. And taking any license, for everybody must have given 5 crore for PMS, from AIF 100, and AMC they pay 100 crores for in their license. So nobody wanted to lose their own personal 100 crore also. So most of the time, these are very, very clear But yes, this question came to me long back with one of the investors. Can they show us how they calculate NAV? In the full document, they will say the formula, but nobody can get disclosed how they are calculating. The calculation only SEBI, if they have questions, they can ask AMC. But as an investor, even as a distributor, we cannot ask.
Yes, ma'am. The next question is from Joydeep. If I have 5 SIP with 3 equity, 1 index fund and 1 debt, what should be the SIP dates in month?
If you are able to manage your money till overall level, you can say 1, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. That's how normal SIP dates are. But what happens most of the time when salaried person people normally say such that by the time end happens, and nowadays banks are also very, very tight. If it is once also that money is not there, insufficient fund, they charge 250 or 450 bucks. So most of the time, what I always believe, and I've been doing personally, my SIP goes first 10 days and my STP goes weekly. So I get actually the best of both worlds. Yeah.
Okay. So the next question is from Jay. What is IPO and how to invest in it?
IPO is an initial public offer, which is for stocks, not linked to the mutual funds. And you need just a DMAT account to apply for it.
Okay, so the next question is, what are the best asset classes to invest for short-term goals?
If it is a short-term goals, I always say it's a better to have it. Sometimes I tell my customer, okay, you can put it in SB and FD accounts, you feel comfortable also. Emergency funds, I always tell them, because I keep telling the investment is a more of an emotional and the behavior, it's not the money. So they should feel comfortable. If it is a short-term, I can redeem anytime money, or it's an emergency, I can redeem anytime money. If it is a short-term goal, I normally go for a debt funds. So I don't go any other funds.
Okay, next question is from Shiv Kumar. What is the advice for first-time mutual fund?
Always, I believe, start small, start long-term disciplined investors. You will see yourself miracles. So first time, if you are not comfortable, start with $1,000 or $2,000, you know, SIP mode. Don't try. That's another question somebody asked me recently. Rashna, why you do an STP? Why don't you do one time and all this stuff? Even it's 2 lakhs or 5 lakhs. So I keep saying, as I told you, we don't know markets. We are not the person who can tell tomorrow market is falling or not. So we believe that how to reduce the risk with the taking care of an averaging. And that's the reason we do, even for a lump sum, we prefer to put it in a liquid funds and do STP over the week-wise risk. Minimum, you can do it. So you defers it. Like if we feel the market may fall sometimes before it goes all-time bull. So we will do 52 weeks of STP.
Next question is from Nitin. What is the percentage of equity and debt and other investments saved by choosing mutual fund?
The first concept normally comes 100 minus your age is in equity, and then you can decide how you are doing it. So like for me, it's a 47. So I will say that 100 minus my age, this should be equity, and 47 can be your PF, PPF, bonds and insurance and FDs if you really want. So you can decide the debt side what you want, and equity you can decide if you want a mutual fund equity, you want a WMS, you want an AIF or a direct stocks. So in that, we will decide how you choose the caps, which will be the next session. I have not taken today cap-wise funds. And there's a lot more, 10 or 13 different types of debt funds are also there. I have not taken that detailing, which I'll be doing soon. But after equity, you will go to the scheme levels and cap-wise and then scheme level.
Okay, so the next question is from Arpita. Can I invest with multiple fund manager?
Means multiple scheme, you mean? Multiple fund managers is a scheme, or you mean that multiple companies or multiple advisors? Can come and speak across to, I'm assuming multiple fund manager means multiple schemes. Yes, you can.
Next question, risk tolerance. How to measure? How often should one has to do?
What you repeat?
Risk tolerance, how to measure, how often should one has to do?
Risk is a very subjective matter. I always tell, when I started with this, you look for a goals. Okay, when you are looking for a goal, you cannot make a risk zero, but you can reduce the risk. So similarly, what we do it, like I'll give you my example. Our daughter is 20 years old. So if I want money for her education, which is after 2 years, I will start putting in a debt fund. So I don't want whatever money for her education we have kept should link to the market. So you try to reduce the risk before the goals. Similarly, you do averaging. You took the longer term. You do the SPP, you reduce the risk. You know that whenever there's a data, facts, whatever you can say, you will get 10 to 12% return if you are in an equity, but when it is in long term. So you don't have to reduce, but if you're thinking in your mind how much you can do, you should look at that angle that if I'm taking a full money in equity, and on a worst scenario, if it's become 40% down, is it it's impacting your lifestyle impact? Then that you cannot do. So you keep reducing that much money that percentage is not impacting your lifestyle. If like your full money is giving a earning from that, you are already in a payout mode, then you can't take a risk. If somebody is already made a corpus and is in retirement mode, you can't take the risk. So you have to decide according to your age what risk you can take and what goal you can take the risk. I saw that question of multiple advisors. Yes, on an average, people, if it is a person who is still 1 crore to 5 crore, they will go maybe one or two people. Nowadays, I've seen people take one and one they will do themselves. But above 5 crore, normally people will have a two advisor. You can go as many advisors you want, but it's a time, money, and effort. You may have to speak with three advisors three times. So people don't want it. Now people want a simplicity and they wanted to have a multiple KJG one person. But you can have any number of advisors, any number of schemes with a different multiple fund managers.
Okay, so the next question, does balanced funds are really balanced with perfect asset allocation as they claim? Because most of the time equity goes up to even 65 to 70% or even more. So when there is cash, we see even called balanced fund really fall freely, no difference from equity.
Yeah, that's another question, good one, which I will take it again. There's a difference between balanced fund and hybrid, we call asset allocation fund or hybrid funds, where they can move across according to the, I can say, market. But on an average, the balanced funds are at 70% of equity and 30% on debt. The reasoning behind it, because as per the income tax rule, 69% and above equity is treated as equity funds, and the taxation comes of equity funds, not as a debt funds. And that's the only reason they always play around to have an averaging 70% of the equity.
Next question is from Jaipal. I'm 35, invest horizon of 20 years, risk-taking investor. How many funds should I have and which category?
We believe that next few years, the mid and small cap will do very good. So on an average, we should always say the SIP should go only on 5 different funds. So if you are fully taking a risk, you may not want it to do the debt funds. You can take a higher on mid and small, and please take it one large and a multi-cap.
The difference between SIP and STP.
So most of the time when we are salaried, we get a monthly income. So we always say 25% of your net investment should go into the investment part. So they do the monthly part, it's an SIP. But somebody says that's not like we used to get the variable pay, or you get the bonus, or you have a lump sum money. Lot of time now, last few months, people have been saying that's not, and now FD is giving me only 3.5% or 4%. I'm moving on full chunk of money. So somebody giving me 10 or 20 lakhs in one shot, I cannot put it in a one because we don't know about market. So what we do, we put it in a liquid funds, and week on week, we move it to the different funds in equity, which is called systematic transfer plan. So it doesn't go from your bank to, it goes to the fund, it goes bank to your liquid funds. And from liquid funds, it goes to the equity funds. On a systematic basis, you can choose any time, but we use trying to use normally a weekly time zone. So that's the difference between SIP and STP, lump sum versus monthly going.
Okay, Okay, next question. What is the best way to invest in ELS fund bulk at FY year end or in SIP mode?
It's a, both the things depends on your discipline, I can say. Because what happened in ELS is if you are doing on a monthly basis, it's good because I go for a lot of corporate for the webinars. And in April, I do first webinar which says that how to declare your tax part of it. So tax declarations is a part of in April. And January, I go when the time of the proof time. So most of the time, they will have declared that I will save ATC 1.5 lakhs. I'll do taking care of a medical insurance also and NPS also. But they must have not invested. In January, they say, okay, I don't have a... Because in a salary, we don't get a bumper salary on December or January. So what happens then? They have to pay the tax. So becoming a better illustration, I will prefer to do monthly. But yes, when they wanted to redeem, that question comes, Krishna, I started 3 years back, but they are not redeeming me a money. So what happens? Because it is a lock-in for 3 years. So the lock-in start the time you have invested. For example, you are putting 10,000 rupees today. So after 3 years, you will, whatever the number of units, that units only it is redeemed. You cannot redeem whatever you have done the full 3 years. So it's not from a starting time. It is for each month on month, whatever you're investing that 3 years plus only you can redeem it. So a lot of people prefer to do like a debt funds for the 11th month. And just before the ELSS, when you have to prove it, you redeem from the full and do it because it's easy to redeem in one shot and put it into that third year rotation of the tax plan. So that's both the reason why people do one lump sum or they do the monthly basis on ELSS.
Okay, next question. What would be an asset allocation for 5 year goal, an aggressive investor?
Actually, I have the screen, but I'll just put it across that was there in my sheet actually. So when it is an aggressive, we were just, this is the funds what we try to do it between a growth scheme, income balance and money, you can say debt funds. So how you should put 70%, 20% taking care of a balance and the rest we are taking care of the debt. This normally we try to say, this help us to make sure most of the time we don't take care of an emergency funds. Every time people says, no, Rishna, I can take risk, you do it. And when I come back to the emergency, this is no, I manage. And that time it's not able to manage, then it may impact because the market is low, you may go low. So most of the time, even though you don't want it, keep it either emergency fund in an FD or in a debt funds, at least 10% or 15% part of it. If not, take an absolute level. Whatever is your 6 monthly expenses you are doing into 6 months, you add it that if you're, I'm just giving an example, if you're spending around 50 to 60,000 in a month, 16 to 6, you do 3.6 lakhs or 4 lakhs, you put it across in your debt fund for an emergency.
Okay, next question. Index fund versus ETF, which is better?
Index fund versus?
ETF.
So both are the similar one. I'm assuming ETF also for benchmark you're doing of the same. But ETF is done on a DMAT and index funds, you can do it on the mutual funds. That's what is the difference. But otherwise, it's the same. Only thing is, it is on the market here and there, it is on the mutual fund. So it is fund of fund kind of it becomes. So if I'm not wrong, it's a platform what is charging you. So ETF should be lesser cost than a fund of fund. I'll take the last three, Nadisha, because I have
yes,
another feeding at
present. Yes, ma'am. Done. Okay, from Akita, with a salary of 1 lakh per month, how should be your invested in SIP or mutual fund in lump sum? Can you help me with a percentage breakup of investment and expenses?
Please write the mail anytime. I will be happy to do it. I'll write it my email. Actually, we will be sending you this webinar video. In that also, it must be there, but I will just write it on my chat also. Yeah. In the second last question.
If I have lump sum to invest, how long should I spread the investment in mutual funds?
As I told you, you should keep it as long as the goal has been linked. But for an STP, you can take it as on 52 weeks.
Okay, last question. you had shown the asset allocation chart depending upon the risk appetite. Is that a asset allocation depending upon goal or reason?
Yes, we do have, because for the kids and all, we will not try to take a longer one. We will try to take a balanced one. So it is depends on the goals and number of prior to the goal also the asset allocation differs.
Yes, ma'am.
So thanks a lot, everybody, joining us on weekend. Have a wonderful weekend and enjoy yourself and spread happiness. Stay safe. Thanks a lot. See you next week. We will have an Alpha series by our PMS team.